One news. Senator, what do you think?
I think it's an exciting day. I think this is a transformative project in the way we do development in Baltimore. It's inclusive. I had the privilege of working with the South Baltimore 6 neighborhood communities. It's remarkable to think what's possible with this moving forward from 6 communities that have been disinvested. We got to maximize the potential and make sure that we get Baltimoreans to work with this project.
What is your advice to would-be entrepreneurs who would consider a place like Port Covington, City Garage, etc.?
Reach out. Ask for assistance. Ask for help. Start making the connections today, because I think Sagamore has demonstrated a commitment to empowering Baltimore. And I think this is the time to really build Baltimore's entrepreneurs.
A general assembly that's about to kick off in 2-3 months or so. What role will the legislature play in the future of Port Covington?
Well, I think it's an ongoing maze. I mean, first and foremost, we got to make sure that we have an education funding formula that works. We got a letter from the Senate President and the Speaker of the House jointly said they're committed to making sure this project enhances Baltimore and in no way is a detriment. We're doing a big review of the education funding formula over the next 2 years. We've got to make sure that this project doesn't impact that. I believe we will, but it's got to be a key focus of the whole delegation. And then we got to make sure that people are getting jobs. At the end of the day, if we don't deal with poverty in Baltimore, we're forever going to be stuck.
You were very helpful in helping me to get an understanding of what's happening here in Port Covington. Can you just give us a little insight on what was happening behind closed doors that people may never hear about?
Yeah, I mean, I think before even the whole city council hearing started, we had the opportunity to pull 6 neighborhoods together in South Baltimore. These 6 neighborhoods had never worked collaboratively on a project in the last 50 years. Very distinct neighborhoods, very powerful leaders, but we're working separately for different ends. We were able to pull those 6 neighborhoods together, start negotiations that a lot of folks didn't see with Sagamore. They were tough, they were hard, but they were real, and they led to an agreement that I think is the model of what we should be looking for when development projects like this happen. So now we have a true partnership between a brand new area of the city and 6 neighborhoods that have been waiting for private investment for years. And so it was quite something to see take place and be a part of, and I think it's